Dante's Boxing Nation, what's going on, guys? So Floyd Mayweather and Marcos Maidana complete their final press conference with only a couple of days left to probably the biggest fight of the year. But this press conference was different because we heard Floyd Mayweather say something that I don't believe he said in any of the previous press conferences, which is he is going for the knockout against Marcos Maidana. Matter of fact, this is exactly what he had to say. Quote, "I need a knockout and I'm going for it. I need to make a statement. First for myself, I want to do it for me." End quote. Now, the majority of the boxing community believes that Floyd Mayweather is going to use a lot more foot movement in this fight to basically guarantee a win over Marcos Maidana. And that could possibly happen. You know, he could be using foot movement just like Miguel Vasquez is going to use a lot of foot movement against Mickey Bay. Now, Floyd Mayweather ain't going to use nowhere near that amount of footwork. But, you know, I've been telling you guys from day one, since this fight has been made, that contrary to what everyone believes, I truly believe that Floyd Mayweather, he is going to use some foot movement. But I think Floyd Mayweather is going to sit in the pocket a lot more than people are expecting him to do. I think he really is going to try to go in there and try to get the knockout. This is a rematch. Floyd Mayweather did win the first fight decisively. You know, Floyd Mayweather makes a very good point when he says, you know, people are used to me winning 12 rounds or 10 out of 12 rounds. Soon as I lose like 3 or 4 rounds, then all of a sudden you got fans saying, you know, Marcos Maidana, he beat him. You know, he won the fight. He beat Floyd's ass, so on and so forth. You hear all this type of, you know, ridiculous talk. So that's basically what made this fight look a lot closer than it really was. I mean, if you didn't know who either one of these fighters was, Mayweather or Maidana, I think the majority of us would clearly say that Floyd Mayweather, he won the fight decisively, okay? But the point that I'm making is when Floyd Mayweather says he wants to go for the knockout, I truly believe he does want the knockout. Now, this is where I have to educate some of the decafs in the boxing world, dumb casual-ass fans. The reason why I bring this up is because you have a lot of uneducated fans that will post messages saying, Floyd never goes for the knockout. He's never trying to get the knockout, so on and so forth, right? What these fans don't understand is, first of all, you're not supposed to desperately go in trying to knock someone out. Floyd Mayweather Sr. said it best. The quickest way to get knocked out is trying to knock someone out. And we've seen a lot of examples. Margarito versus Shane Mosley. Ricky Hatton versus Manny Pacquiao. Carras versus Keith Thurman. The list goes on and on and on. Usually when fighters get knocked out on this level, the elite level, usually it's from a big mistake that a fighter makes. Basically like fumbling the ball, right? This is usually when you get a knockout, like when Marquez knocked out Pacquiao. Marquez, he took a step back. Manny Pacquiao, he reached in, left himself wide open, right? He made a huge mistake. And Marquez capitalized off of the mistake that Manny Pacquiao made. When Floyd Mayweather was fighting against an undefeated Ricky Hatton, you guys have to understand something. Nobody expected Floyd Mayweather to knock out Ricky Hatton. He had never been knocked out before. I think he had only been knocked down like once or twice, but he had never been knocked out before. No one would have ever expected Floyd Mayweather to knock him out. And if you look at the way Floyd Mayweather was fighting, you wouldn't necessarily say he was going in there with mean intentions to knock out Hatton, right? So the Ricky Hatton fight, what it proves is you can knock out a fighter many different ways. You can knock out a fighter just going after them, bobbing and weaving, and maybe catching them with a good counter, or maybe just throwing a wild-ass haymaker that lands. You can knock them out that way. You can also knock out a fighter the way Floyd Mayweather knocked out Ricky Hatton, which is setting up traps, right? Setting up a trap. You throw a punch, if you think about it, the way Mayweather knocked out Hatton was very similar to how Marquez knocked out Pacquiao. Both fighters took a quick step back and they came back with a counter shot. Marquez countered with the right hand. Floyd Mayweather, he countered with a left check hook, right? Even in the Diego Corrales fight, the way Floyd Mayweather was boxing, to the naked eye, to the casual fan, you wouldn't expect Floyd Mayweather to knock out Diego Corrales. A lot of you guys have to understand something. At the time that Floyd Mayweather knocked out Diego Corrales, Diego Corrales was the most durable fighter in the sport of boxing. Diego Corrales, he had the best chin in the sport of boxing. He had that type of Antonio Margarito chin. And guess who was the one that knocked him out? Another thing I think you guys should think about is Diego Corrales, he was in the ring with very hard punchers. Fighters like Asilino Popo Freitas, who was one of the hardest punchers at the time. Okay? He was in the ring with an undefeated Robert Garcia, who Robert Garcia at the time was very good. Probably even better than Mikey Garcia is today. I don't know, but Robert Garcia was really good as a lightweight champion. Okay? Or I believe it was junior lightweight. But nonetheless, all of these fighters, they fought Diego Corrales, and they couldn't even knock him down. But Floyd Mayweather did. So how is that possible? It's simple. The punch that you don't see is the punch that creates the most damage. And it doesn't always have to be the hardest punch in the world. It could just be a perfectly timed shot that you didn't brace yourself for. Right? How do you guys think Suge Knight got knocked out by a guy that was damn near a 105? Suge Knight got knocked out by a guy that was half his size. Why? Because Suge Knight got caught slipping. He got caught with a shot he never even braced himself for. Right? So this is why I want you guys to understand, you don't have to be the hardest puncher in the world to knock someone out. You don't have to be the hardest puncher in the world to even ding a guy, to daze him, to rock him, to stun him, right? I mean, if you guys watched Marcos Maidana interview, I did an interview with Marcos Maidana, and he said that Floyd Mayweather has very respectable power. He said you can't, you know, he's not the hardest puncher in the world, but he has respectable power. You gotta be careful with him. This is what Marcos Maidana said. Now, they didn't show that part of Marcos Maidana saying that in the All Access, you know, broadcast. But that's what he said. Matter of fact, you guys can go back. You know, my full interview, you guys see me on All Access interviewing Marcos Maidana. But if you want to watch that full interview, I have it on my channel. Okay, I probably will put the link up. I might even put it up on this video right here. But anyway, so that's what Marcos Maidana, he said. Respectable power is what Floyd Mayweather has. You don't have to be a massive power puncher to knock someone out. All you have to do is set a trap and hope that they fall for the trap or they fall into the trap, right? I mean, we've seen what Floyd Mayweather did to Victor Ortiz's face after only four rounds. A fighter who has no power doesn't do that to his opponents, okay? Even Canelo Alvarez, a guy who was damn near 20 pounds bigger than Floyd Mayweather, he had a mouse under his eye, all right, by someone who was much smaller than he was. So, once again, Floyd Mayweather, yeah, is obviously not the hardest puncher in the world, but he is a decent puncher, and that's all you need is a decent punch to knock someone out and catch them slipping. I'm sure a lot of you guys played Fight Night before, right? When you play Fight Night, what is the main punch that stuns your opponent? It is the counter punch, right? It is the punch that you do not see, the punch that you don't expect coming. And it works the exact same way in the real sport of boxing. So the question is, can Floyd Mayweather knock out Marcos Maidana? Absolutely. Absolutely. He can definitely knock out Marcos Maidana. That doesn't mean it's going to happen, but I'm just saying he has a chance of knocking Maidana out. Another thing you have to consider as well is Marcos Maidana, if he's worried about being knocked out, if he fights a little passive, that may prevent Floyd Mayweather from getting the knockout. But if Marcos Maidana goes balls to the wall and he really tries to press the issue like he's saying he's going to do, that gives Floyd Mayweather his best chance to knock Marcos Maidana out. Once again, I go back to the Ricky Hatton situation and the Diego Corrales situation. Those guys got knocked out because they were being overly aggressive. Sometimes being aggressive can actually work against you if you're being too aggressive, if you're using too much of your heart and not too much of your brain, right? So Floyd Mayweather is going to be hoping that Maidana actually does something like that, uses a little too much of his heart and leaves himself wide open. We'll see. You know, another thing I thought was pretty interesting is Marcos Maidana and his team, they're saying that they're going to come in lighter this time. They think they were a little too sluggish coming in damn near 20 pounds heavier than Floyd Mayweather. I thought that was pretty interesting because what I got out of that is it makes me feel that they purposely came in the ring as heavy as they could. You got to remember, Marcos Maidana is training with a trainer who tells him to fight dirty. So if Robert Garcia told him to fight dirty before the fight, imagine what Robert Garcia was saying to Maidana, you know, weeks and months before the fight, leading all the way up to the day the fight took place, right? I mean, there's a very good possibility that Robert Garcia was telling Maidana, we should come in as heavy as possible. Let's try to get every advantage we can get over this bastard, is probably what they were saying, right? Let's try to come in 18, 20 pounds bigger. We're going to have a 20-pound weight advantage over him. We're going to be way younger than him. And then you're going to be dirty as hell. I want you kicking his ass. I want you slamming him to the ground, doing whatever you can do, right? This was the game plan. And now they believe at least the weight advantage part of the game plan may have backfired. So the question is, will it make a big difference if Maidana comes in lighter this time? Him being quicker, him being, you know, having more stamina, I should say. Will it make a difference? I don't think it'll make a difference. But Maidana, he's so wild, he can easily catch Floyd Mayweather with a shot, okay? That's what makes this rematch so intriguing. And I truly believe a lot of the fans that you hear say, oh, you know, this fight is BS and so on and so forth. I wouldn't be surprised if deep down they truly are anxious to watch this rematch. Because there's a lot of things that can happen in this fight. Like I said, Floyd could actually knock down Maidana, maybe knock him out. Maidana can knock out Floyd Mayweather. Anything is possible. And I truly believe there's going to be a lot of fans that are starting to believe the hype, believe the Maidana hype. And a lot of late money is going to come in. And when I say late money, I'm talking about paying for the pay-per-views. It's going to come in and people are going to start praying and hoping that Maidana can land that lucky shot. So we'll see. We'll see what happens, guys. That's all I got. I'm on to the next one.